Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we are going to be learning more of HTML. We'll be diving into some of the text tags like headings, paragraph tag, and we'll be looking at div. So without any further ado, let's jump into the video. In the previous video, we had created this folder called HTML and we had created a file inside that, which is called as index.html. I've also added a image, so we'll be using that image too in this video. So first we like learn some terminologies in HTML. So first, when you write, let's say h1, and then you write hello world. So out here, the h1, this is called as the opening tag, and this is called as a closing tag. And what is written inside the tag, like between the opening and closing tag, is called as a content. And the whole thing is called as an element. These are some of the terminologies. First off, we'll start by learning the various headings there. Now, each heading has a different kind of size to it and a boldness to it. Starting with H1, it goes on till H6, like H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, and H6. H1 being the most bold and the biggest in size, and H6 being the least bold and the smallest in size. Now I have like written a bunch of headings starting with H1 till H6. We'll save this and we'll open it with live server to see what is the result. Now you can see I've written H1 in hello world, so that's the most bold one. Then H2, then H3, H4, H5 and H6. So these are six different headings in HTML. Next off, we'll go ahead and we'll see what is the p tag. The p tags, written like opening p tag and closing p tag, are called as a paragraph tag, where you write the content which you want. Like for example, in a blog post, you write the heading using one of these h tags and you write the content inside the blog post using the p tag. Okay, I have a famous quote by Audrey, which is, life is very short and what we have to do must be done in the now. So this is something which you can think about, but for now I'll just put this as a tag, as a text there. If you save this, and let's say since it's working with live server, as you save it in your file, it displays it in the web browser. Okay, you can see the difference. The p tag does not have that boldness to it, and this is the size of it. This is what you can use CSS to increase the size of it, which we'll learn later, but this is the normal size fixed by HTML5. In HTML5, like a family tree, we have parent, children, grandchildren, and that's how it works. Also, if you see, HTML is like the parent, which is like the outside one, and inside there you have two children, which is the head tags and the body tag. Inside the head tag, whatever tags you have would be the grandchildren for HTML and children for head. And similarly, in the body tag, these h1s, h2s and all the headings and the p tag are grandchildren to HTML and children to body. These are some of the terminologies that will help you understand when you like talk with someone who's in the web development industry, who's writing HTML code, for example. Next, we'll go ahead and we'll learn what are divs. Divs, which are called as divisions, are basically sections. You want to put your code in separate sections, so you group them up. Like let's say if I want one particular blog content to be in separate group, I group it under a div. Then another block content and another. So I use divs to put them in a separate section so it's easier to access them whenever I need. So how you write that division tag is using div. So you do div and then you do that, and there's a closing tag for that too. This is how divs work. And inside the div, you can write your content which will be in a separate section by themselves. Let's say I write a heading under h1 and I write some content under p. Here I've written a small heading called dogs versus cats, and I've written some text. People love pets, some like dogs and some like cats. So what I've written, I'll save this, and you can see, you cannot see much of a difference out here, but once you include CSS, like you style it up, let's say I use some styling out here for this separate div. Let's say I use a style tag inside the head tag and I write some style for a separate div, like background color, to show you that this section has a different color altogether. Let's say I go ahead and style it using the style tag and I say div and give a background color for that called gray to show you the section, but don't go into this right now. I'll tell you about this in the later sections where we learn about CSS, not HTML. So this is called as a background color, and I put it for just for this div out here so I can show you that this is a separate section from the other content we have. Now I go ahead and save this. Now I have a background to this, only for this div. Whatever is inside this div has a background color. And let's say I go ahead and include an image inside that div to show you how that image works. I have an image called coding.jpg. I go ahead and use the image tag. In the image tag, you have two elements other than the image text, image img text itself. One is a source and other is the alt. Source tells you where the image is taken from. Let's say I take the coding.jpg image. To say that this is taken from that same folder where this file is in, you use a dot and a slash, and then you get what our content is. I'm using coding.jpg. That's the image I'm using. And this alt text, it's for places where the browser cannot find this image. And you must have seen the image is like a wallpaper where a person is sitting. I'll just put as coding wallpaper. And now once I save this, since the browser is able to show this image, the image would be shown. And you can see that the image is pretty big. So the browser can show the image. But let's say I make some mistakes in this. Like for example, I add another G out here. And if I save it now, you can't see the image, but you can see the alt text which says, okay, this is a coding wallpaper. That's what the alt text does. And this really helps to show, or let's say a person with visual disability is viewing it. He uses some web browser reading technology and he does it. That's when the alt text would be helpful, and also in the cases where the source is not aligned properly. Now that's it from me in this video. In this video we have learned some of the HTML keywords, and then we have learned about headings, we have learned about paragraphs, we have learned about divs, divisions, we have learned how to use the image tag. And in the next video we'll learn more of HTML and we'll dive deeper into HTML, and I'll tell you how to actually go ahead and create a web page, like just the basic structure of it. If you look at HTML, it's like the structure, like the skeleton of the building, and you use CSS to make it look much better, like the paintings, the wall colors, the photographs, and everything is done by CSS. JavaScript is used for more like an interactive way to connect between each of the elements and everything. So in the next video, we'll dive deeper into that skeleton and I'll tell you more about that skeleton, and we'll go ahead and we'll create a small page with just that skeleton out there. So that's from me in this video. Thanks a lot for watching this.